Mr. Fidel.
It wasn't easy for immigration officer Jeffrey Del Ignacio to identify his co-workers and superiors in their role in the visa upon arrival bribery scheme. He says he didn't have a choice since he did not have the 200,000 peso being asked by a lawyer in exchange for being left out of the investigation. He chose instead to be a whistleblower. He was also seen in the videos and pictures submitted as evidence of bribery in the arrival of Chinese nationals in the airport.
Malungkot ako dahil kasama ko yung mga yan eh. Nakasama ko sila sa ilang taong ko sa bureau. Siyempre, mahirap din para sa akin. Pero kailangan kong gawin eh. Kailangan kong magsabi ng totoo. Para once and for all, matigil na din yung corruption sa BI.
Ignacio started his career in the bureau in 2009 and he was invited to be a part of the bribery scheme. He eventually agreed to join in 2017 after they stopped receiving overtime pay and was left with his monthly 19,000 salary for his family.
Nung ni-recruit ako, hindi ko talaga tinanggap yung offer the first time kasi ayoko talagang sumali sa mga ganitong katiwalian sa bureau. Pero since nga na ang sabi ko dun sa nag-recruit sa akin, mangungutang na lang muna ako kasi nawalan ako ng choice nun eh. Nung nagkandabaon-baon ako sa utang. So kailangan kumapit sa patalin.
According to the NBI, his testimony strengthened the allegations of his fellow immigration officers and witness, Alison Chong. The NBI adds, more immigration personnel are being investigated.
Meron talaga kaming shaken batch na. Yung mga natirang hindi nakasuhan, sisikapin po namin makasuhan lahat at baka may maidagdag pa po kasi may mga nabanggit na mga bagong pangalan.
This is not the first time the Bureau of Immigration faced a serious investigation. In 2016, Deputy Commissioners Al Argosino and Michael Robles were charged after allegedly extorting 50 million pesos from businessman Jack Lam for the release of his Chinese workers who illegally entered the country. Last year, 18 immigration agents and employees were charged after allegedly extorting and abducting Korean nationals who are threatened with deportation.
Before pa nang dumating ako sa bureau, may mga ganyan ng racket ang BIA. So siguro hindi sila natatakot. Kasi may bas-bas nga sa taas.
Ignacio hopes his entry into the witness protection program will not be in vain and the results of the investigation will trigger reforms in the Bureau of Immigration. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.